Hey everybody, my name is Brendan Noble and I'm a young adult author. Sorry I missed last week's video, it was a busy week and I just didn't get to making one, but I'm back and I'm back with the most depressing topic I could think of for Valentine's Day, because why not? And that topic is what to do when your book isn't selling, because I'm experiencing this kind of personally a little bit lately, so I thought it would be an interesting thing to talk about with all of you. So let's get started as I go over kind of a step-by-step process of things to look at and see how you can fix things of your book and maybe right the ship. Step one is cry. I mean, this is kind of obvious. You're gonna be really unhappy, cry about it, eat some ice cream, really feel bad about yourself, and then move on from the step as quickly as possible. And step two is then put your pants back on, put away the ice cream, stop crying, and evaluate the situation. There's a lot of different things that can go wrong with a book. Your blurb could be bad, which is encouraging people maybe to go to your page, but not encouraging people to buy the book. Your cover could be unprofessional or not right for the genre. Those aren't necessarily the same thing. There are some great covers that don't fit the genre. So people might be misjudging your book and not buying it because of that. There might be some formatting errors on the look inside. So when people take a look at your book, and when they click that look inside on Amazon, things don't look right. There can be ads, there could be a lot of different things that go wrong, and you need to be able to take a step back and try to be an impartial observer here and figure out what's going wrong. Now, this can be difficult to do because sometimes our book is our baby, so it can really help if you have either writer friends or marketing friends, especially because a lot of these problems tend to be marketing. Take a look at it and see if they have any ideas about what's going wrong or what you could do better. A big key about this process is don't take it personally. Again, this your book is a product. It's not your baby. And especially when you're marketing a book, a lot of us have written good books and you might have great reviews on the book. But if you're not marketing it well, it won't sell well. So being able to look back and address some of these things will help you evaluate where you need to go in the future. And you have to do that impartially, or otherwise you're not gonna fix it. So step three is going about fixing some of the problems that you've identified. If you have an issue with your blurb, either the grammar's not great, it doesn't have a good hook, it's not really catching the reader at the end to convince them to click the buy button or something like that, you can look for help on Facebook groups searching for advice with what to do to fix your blurb. You can look at my video that I'll link down below where I talk about the mechanics of writing a good blurb and how that could work. You can check out books like Brian Kaplan's How to Write a Sizzling Synopsis. There's a lot of different things that help out there. If you designed your own cover and the cover's not working right, you can hire a cover designer or at least get someone else to help you figure out what cover will work for your book. If it's the look inside, you can work on the formatting of the book. And that's something that's great because as self-published authors, we can upload new files, the look inside will be updated, and that can be fixed. All of these things can be fixed without needing necessarily a new ISBN number or having to lose all your reviews on Amazon or Goodreads or anything like that. So a lot of these things are fixable very quickly, and being able to be in the right mindset to fix those things and know who to reach out to fix them is very powerful. I literally just got a notification on my watch here that my Kindle blurb was just updated myself because I've been going through this process and trying to A and B test what blurbs work with different advertising on both Amazon and Facebook and things like that. Because again, you have to be able to evaluate, and then once you make some of those fixes, this is kind of step four, reevaluate. Test what works, see if these changes have fixed things. Maybe it's a series of things you need to fix. Maybe it's just how you've classified the book. Maybe it's in the wrong categories. So reevaluate some of these things and see if, what changes you can make, and then redo step three as many times as you need to try to make it work. See, if you've written a good book and you're getting good reviews on the book, the problem has to be your marketing then. And being able to work with marketing, it's fixable. Marketing is an art and not a science, but there's a lot of marketing experts out there that we can work with to make it work as best as possible. So write the best book you can, always focus on that. And if your book's not selling well, then work with the experts to make it happen. And step five is just keep writing. I mean, the best possible thing you can keep doing is write. And if you're, especially if you're in a series, if book one's not selling well and you're still working on book two, don't worry about book one. The more books you write in a series, you inherently get a little bit more interest in the book as people see that the series is finished. Some people won't buy a series till they see the entire series has been published. So that's something to take into consideration. Also, your writing is going to improve with time. For example, if your book is not selling well because it got bad reviews or the writing's poor, keep writing and keep getting better at writing. It is an art that takes time to perfect. A lot of the best authors out there are still getting better, and they say they're getting better with each book. So if they can improve, obviously we can as well. Part of book selling is also just luck. I wish I couldn't say that, but it is. There's a element of writing a good book, but then there's also an element of selling. And sometimes people just pick up a book and all of a sudden it catches fire. There's a lot of bad books that have sold really well, and there's a lot of really, really good books that have sold extremely poorly. So the key is making sure your book is a good book that sells well. And some of that is going to be luck. And if you keep writing, eventually you have an increased chance of hitting that gold mine. And if someone hits that gold mine, they'll try to read your backlist often. And so having more books in that backlist for people to read can be extremely powerful. So do not feel down if your book is selling poorly. I felt this myself, but keep doing what you do. Write well, figure out what's wrong, figure out how to fix the problems, and then keep moving forward. This is the great thing about if you're a self-publisher, you can fix things. You can make the book better. You can make the marketing better. But the key is don't get depressed and give up, because if you do that, your book will never sell better. And so the best people that have become the best authors often don't get it on their first try. Find your favorite author that isn't named J.K. Rowling and go see where their first books are ranked. They tend to be pretty poor often, and that's because they improve in time as well, and this is a process. So keep working on the process, keep doing better, and this is what I keep telling myself as well. So I'm not just lecturing to you, I'm trying to tell myself this as well. It's a process, it takes time, keep writing, keep getting better, and hopefully in the long run, well, you'll all be famous, you'll all be rich, and we can all share in the spoils and laughs of what happened when our books weren't selling well and we look back. So that's all I have for you guys today on that somewhat depressing note. Happy Valentine's Day to everybody. I hope that everybody with the significant others is having a great time. And I hope that everyone's enjoying writing romance or not in whatever book you're working on. So have a great week, and I'll see you all next Friday.